Welcome all. Today I am going to explain fixed length subnet masking with the help of this particular demonstration. So in this demonstration I need to do FLSM. So what is my network requirement? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So as I told you in the previous video, you can take the help of some of the steps which helps you understanding the process of subnetting and make this process is very much easier. So first step is identify subnet bit. So how many bit we need to borrow from the host side to completing this subnetting process, it is called subnet bits. So we know that with one bit borrow we can make two networks, but my requirement is five network, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. With 2 bits borrow we can make 4 networks, so which is less than my requirement. With 3 bit we can 8, so we go for the 8 possible. We will go for the 8 because we always go either equal to the requirement or more than the requirement. We never go for less than the requirement. So how many subnet bit we require? 3. In the second step, what is the default subnet mask? 255.255.255, and I need to borrow 3 subnet bits. So network bits or subnetwork bits is always represented by 1. So how many bits belongs to the user in the C class? 8 bits. So how many bits we need to borrow? We need to borrow 3 bits. So most significant 3 bits are get converted into the 1. When you are convert this binary values into the decimal, so we will convert with this particular formula. It is very easy conversion. If you don't aware about the conversion, kindly study about that, how to convert binary values into the decimal. So only 8th bit, 7th and 6th is 1. So we convert it, and in the step 2 we are able to find out updated subnet mask. With the step 3 we need to calculate what is the range. So for the formula I use for calculating the range, maximum subnet mask minus calculated subnet mask, you will get the range. So what we get the range? No change in first octet, no change in second octet, no change in third octet. Add 31 in 4th octet. So first subnetwork starts from 192.168.10.0. So no change in first octet, no change in second octet, no change in third octet. Add 31 in 4th octet. So the first subnetwork is completed. Second subnetwork is going to start from 192.168.10. Till 31 we consume, so start from 32. So no change in first, no change in second, no change in third. So add 31 in 4th octet. So what is the range of second subnetwork is 32 to 63. Similarly for the third subnetwork is 64 plus 31, 95. Fourth, 96 to 127. Fifth, 128 to 159. Now I am going to process use to provide IP addressing. So for PC0, which belongs to network 0 to 31, this is the network address, this is the broadcast address. So first usable IP I am going to provide 10.2, because all first valid IP is always provided to the default gateway. You can provide any, but I usually follow approach to provide first valid IP to the default gateway. Subnet mask, updated subnet mask and default gateway. PC1 is done. Similarly, PC2 10.3, updated subnet mask and default gateway. Done. Come to the interface fast ethernet 0/0. It belongs to this network. So go on the router, configuration, fast ethernet 0/0, and I want to provide IP address 192.168.10.1, which is the first valid IP of this network, and change subnet mask to 224. Don't forget to change your subnet mask and switch it on. Network 1 configuration done. Similarly, in network 2, go on the PC. It's having IP address 34 because it belongs from the network 32 to 63. First valid IP is 33, which I will provide to my gateway. You can check. Now this is the 34. This is the 35. Now come to the interface. Fast Ethernet 0/0 is connecting this network to the router. So what is the my default gateway? 10.33. Don't forget to change the subnet mask 224. Switch it on. Similarly, for the third subnetwork, we are going to provide the IP address. It belongs to 64 to 95. So 65 is the first valid IP which is provided to a gateway. So 66. Similarly, for this PC, 67. Now provide to this interface fast Ethernet 0/0. Now for this interface, I am going to provide 65, and don't forget to update the subnet mask. Switch it on. Now coming to this network, serial 2/0, 96 to 127. So click on serial 2/0 and provide the first valid IP 192.168.10.97 subnet mask 224. Okay, correct. Now come serial 2/0 again, subnet mask as IP address is 98. Done. So we have done with the four network. Last network started from 128, first valid IP is 129, and it's connected on serial 3/0. So serial 3/0 129, subnet mask 224. Now serial 2/0 130, subnet mask is 224. Done. We have done with the IP addressing using FLSM when we need to divide into the 8 subnets, and here available subnet scenarios are 5. So thank you. The routing process you can see into the next video.